You're late.
I stopped to pick up your perfume.
There's a man here who wants to buy our brownstone. Lester McSomething or other. He's a friend of the realtor.
Our brownstone isn't for sale.
It might be. You should hear the numbers he's throwing around.
Really? Okay. Guess it doesn't hurt to listen. Lester, right? Hello, Lester.
You must be Samuel. What a pleasure. What a garden. I love daffodils.
My wife tells me you're interested in buying our house.
They say gifting a bouquet of daffodils ensures happiness. Well, presenting just one means bad luck is on the horizon.
Hey, boys. I hope you're hungry.
I have a triple creme, some Jarlsberg, water biscuits, and my mother's famous cucumber dip.
That sounds delicious, Cynthia. Tragically, there's no time for snacks. Well, maybe some of Mom's famous cucumber dip.
Who are you? What do you want?
You recently contracted Halcyon for a job on behalf of your company. I'd like to know the details.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Cynthia, is that a touch of cayenne in there? What a nice little kick.
Samuel, just tell him.
Tell me what?
It's about oil.
Shut up, Cynthia.
No, I will not shut up, Samuel. He has got a gun. A competitor of Vestin's is buying oil from terrorists, the really bad ones. So Vestin hired Halcyon to get involved for some reason. I don't know what. Tell him, Samuel, you're doing nothing wrong. These people are evil.
I can't believe this.
I read his emails. Ever since I found him with a nanny, I look at everything.
We don't even have a nanny. It was a movie.
A nanny movie?
Not just nannies. School teachers, nurses, and a ridiculous threesome with two completely unbelievable police women.
Cynthia, they're just movies. I have never cheated on you. And besides, I don't think he wants to hear about it.
Yes, I want to hear about it, all about it. Unfortunately, I do need to hear about your contract with Halcyon. So, business first, and then, Cynthia, I'll be all ears.